Hey guys, it's Macy. Today, I want to address solar panel detach and reinstalls. What does it look like? Does it affect your insurance? And how much does it cost? So let's get started. So the most common reasons that we see solar panels needing to be detached and reinstalled here in Texas are due to age, hail, and poor quality installs from other installers that need to be rebuilt to produce better energy results for your home. How do we determine which panels need to be replaced? We use a thermal drone. For a full explanation from our drone expert Franz, check out our thermal drone interview down below. But to sum it up, we'll fly a super cool drone to examine your roof better than most insurance companies will, who will just come out, sometimes not even get on top of your roof, before giving you an understated coverage amount, leaving you paying more out of pocket. Is solar covered by insurance? Most importantly, solar is not always covered by default. Sometimes it is, but check with your insurance provider and don't assume. With some insurance providers, it can cost about $50 a year to cover your solar, but it is an additional add-on. Once it's covered, a solar insurance claim isn't much different from a traditional roof claim. They're generally coupled together in the same claim, and warranty coverage should be added as soon as possible. We just ran into a less than 6-month-old system where we reinstalled 95% of their panels due to hail, and the homeowner did not cover PV under insurance. Our amazing project management team will help you along the way, ensuring as your install approaches, you get your panels covered. Can you reuse the same solar equipment during reinstall? Unless damaged or completely non-functional, our installers will reuse as much of your system that we can. Also, on occasion, someone has mounting equipment such as rails, etc., that no longer are available, so we have to switch to something that we can get parts for. Often, systems will have stripped bolts and whatnot and can't be replaced, so we need to modernize it. Can solar panels be damaged for other reasons other than that baseball-sized Texas hail? Hopefully not. They can get paint scrapes and are sometimes chewed up by squirrels and other animals. But install, removal, and reinstalls are a difficult and indelicate process, so things are commonly slightly damaged cosmetically. But this is pretty much avoidable, short of using a crane. But it won't be noticeable from the ground generally, and a thermal drone can detect any damages. And if we functionally damage something, we'll replace it on our dime. So how is your warranty impacted? If your original installer is available, you should use them to save the warranty. If you're an original Good Faith Energy customer, the original warranty will stand, but it does not restart upon reinstall. Reengineering. Do you need it? When? And how much engineering comes into play when reinstalling a system that was already engineered and installed on your roof? Well, reengineering can occur for many reasons. Adding capacity, adding batteries, if your original system was not installed correctly, or if you want to change major components due to technology advancements, or if there's a product that really catches your eye, like a Powerwall 3, for example. What is the cost of the detach and reinstall versus getting an entirely new system? Effectively, it's the same cost minus major materials such as batteries, panels. Around a third to half of the new cost is labor. We at times recommend that some customers get a new roof prior to installing their system to avoid more detach and reinstalls in the long run. If we install on a 20-year shingle roof, it can cause more complications later on when it's time for those shingles to go. If you've experienced solar panel damage or just any roof damage at all due to the Texas storms, call us today or fill out a service form at goodfaithenergy.com/service. And whether we installed it or not, we'll be here for you. Till next time, I'm Macy. Y'all stay safe out there.